In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of posterior part of shoulder joint. I am going to explain two nerves and important muscles with nerves. Okay? I am going to explain this nerve first. This yellow wire represents nerve. This is axillary nerve. This is very, very important nerve. And it kind of rounds around neck of humerus. That means this nerve is very close to shoulder joint, okay? And this nerve innervates two muscles. One is this one. This red tape actually represents teres minor, okay? Teres minor. This is one of rotator cuff muscles, okay? The one more muscle is like here. You don't see in this video. So this kind of muscle, this is deltoid. So axillary nerve innervates teres minor and deltoid muscle. Okay. Then I'm going to explain this nerve. So this nerve is suprascapular nerve. Suprascapular nerve. And it kind of has a very unique pathway. It originates from, you know, cervical spine. Imagine there is a cervical spine here, then running like this, and passes scapula here, here, and curves around here, and it kind of bifurcates here. So basically, it has two branches, suprascapular nerve. This nerve innervates two muscles, actually three. The one is supraspinatus. You don't see in this video. It runs like this. Supraspinatus. This is one of rotator cuff muscles as well. And infraspinatus covers like this, covers the whole surface of posterior part of scapula like this. Supraspinatus, infraspinatus, and it depends on the textbook. Very few information says suprascapular nerve innervates teres minor. But I think it's very rare. Most of the anatomy books does not show teres minor is innervated by suprascapular nerve. I think it's very minor information, but I think it depends on the research or article. Maybe suprascapular nerve innervates teres minor, just for your information, you know. And these two nerves, axillary nerve and suprascapular nerve, innervates the shoulder joint itself. I'll be more specific. These two nerves takes information from joint capsule of shoulder joint. That's very interesting, right? And very important. If shoulder joint got injury or ruptured, it has to take information from somebody, right? Then these two nerves take information from shoulder joint capsule. This is very important. Axillary nerve and suprascapular nerve. Then I'm going to explain this part, this relationship with axillary nerve. You remember this red tape? This is teres minor, okay? Then this blue one is teres major, okay? Teres major. This one is long head of triceps brachii. Long head of triceps brachii, teres major, and teres minor. What are these things? What matter in this video? So what's important thing is here, this tiny space. It's kind of a rectangular shape right here. You see? This space is very, very important because axillary nerve passes through this space. So this space is composed by teres minor, teres major, long head of triceps brachii, and humerus here. The name of this space is quadrilateral space because its shape is like a quadrilateral, rectangular, right? So if this space is diminished, it can create impingement for axillary nerve. If axillary nerve got impingement, it can irritate teres minor, deltoid, or shoulder joint. Remember, axillary nerve takes information from joint capsule. And one more thing, axillary nerve is very close to neck of humerus. You know, neck of humerus oftentimes get fracture here. Or shoulder joint sometimes get dislocation. What happens if shoulder joint get dislocation or humerus gets fracture? It can affect axillary nerve or teres minor or transverse brachii or teres major. Then these dysfunction can affect axillary nerve, shoulder joint, or these muscles. That is why this space, quadrilateral space, is very, very important for shoulder joint, especially for posterior part. I have to repeat, axillary nerve takes information from shoulder joint capsule. Also, suprascapular nerve takes information from joint capsule as well. So in this video, I explained very important anatomy of posterior part of scapula and shoulder joint. I explained axillary nerve. This nerve innervates deltoid and teres minor, and it takes information from shoulder joint. This is suprascapular nerve. It innervates supraspinatus, infraspinatus, and sometimes anatomy book says suprascapular nerve also innervates teres minor. Then don't forget, suprascapular nerve also takes information from shoulder joint capsule. So if you liked today's video, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.